Alright, this time we're successfully live with The Sims 4. Plan today is to build a home. I am in Willow Creek. I was planning on building an expensive home just across the street from the Goss. You can see it's a very richy looking area. One of the nice things to use in build mode is T, so it goes from a top down perspective. It's helpful when you're working in smaller rooms. You can draw straight walls like before, or entire rooms. But one of the neat things is they also added some pre-made shapes. Then with that, you can grab it and drag. And one mistake I constantly make is when you have a room selected and you hit the comma or period now, instead of rotating your view, it rotates the room, and I do that a lot. It's one of the weird quirks for me. Pick up an entire room or even the whole house if you want to and move it. That looks like a ridiculously big shape. So when you have the room selected, you can also pick the size of the wall and that'll adjust the walls. That'll adjust the walls for the entire floor. With bigger walls, there's additional options for doors and windows that'll fit the height. You could still use the smaller ones, so. Though. When you use the design tool, you get the color options again, so if you're like me and forget to pick a color before placing something, you can adjust it after it's placed. Since I picked the smallest wall size, the door got undone because it was a medium-sized door. Windows you can place on various heights as long as they're small enough to slide up and down. No, there's no extra charge for changing a design. It's kind of like, it's basically their version of customizing the design like you did with the swatches on Sims 3, but you can't pick different patterns and all that. You can just use their preset designs. So that's one part where the build mode's kind of lacking compared to Sims 3. Wall patterns are basically the standard fare from previous Sims. But it auto-adds the edging when you did an entire wall, which is really, really cool. So you just hold down shift and it paints the entire outside of your house. You do start with a basic drywall paint inside your house, so that way your Sims aren't all sad about not having paint on the walls if you forget to spot. Before I forget, I should place stairs for a second floor. I forgot that in my house I made the first day, and I had to place stairs outside to get to a second floor, and that was kind of sad. Stairs are a lot easier to work with than this one. As I just accidentally did, they turn the same way that you can with room. And with them selected, you have arrows so you can drag and widen them. I can't wait for them to put in elevators and spiral staircases at some point, or at least I hope they do. It's really strange to have a Sims without elevators. So you just have a simple click and it adds the railing. It's the first time I've done that, so I had no idea it would be that easy. So one other thing you can do with stairs, it's really, really awesome. Pick a different type, just click on where your current stairs are and it replaces them. You don't have to delete them, you don't have to try to refit them, nothing. Just completely replace them that way. There we go, that looks nice. I wonder where that keeps going. Weird! When in doubt, use the old ways. Yeah, it seems like a completely impractical room. How sad it doesn't center. Ooh, it doesn't like that. There is a way to go into like a tweaking mode with this, so you're not always snapping to the grid. I don't recall what it is offhand though, but I remember them mentioning it when they were live streaming it last week. You Trying to steal the balcony idea from next door here. Looks nice enough. Just three clicks and place the balcony fence up. That's all kinds of fancy, huh? As you just saw, the floors have different heights, so each floor can have its own height. they need more color options on these. This is kind of neat though. No, it's not bad that you keep trying to click on stuff. When I was doing the highlights of yesterday's live stream, I kept trying to click my screen to adjust the camera, and that's bad. I like the little balcony things, but I'm not sure how they quite fit with this. Yeah, you think so? I'm not sure. I'd have to place one in an active household and see if my Sim can walk onto it. Now that's nice and fancy. Buying stuff like this is much easier when you remember to hold down shift while you're placing it. have to admit, I'm not sure how they got a banister up on the roof level. It's not letting me do it. Yeah, it's not letting me apply a fence either. I bet they made it a room temporarily and then applied it. They can turn walls into a fence, apparently. Thank you. There we go, that looks a bit better, huh?